understanding fire dynamics is key to successful fire ground operations. The training environment creates an unrealistic fire dynamic situation that would not be found in a residential structure. ULFSRI's 2014 DHS project is looking to quantify the fire training environment. Today, we're at the Delaware County Emergency Services Training Center, looking to quantify fire dynamics in a concrete burn building. Creating ventilation-limited fire conditions is difficult in a burn building. The fuel restrictions, along with the natural ventilation provided around windows, doors, and scupper holes, make it difficult for the fire to run out of oxygen. Using three different fuel packages, a common training fire fuel of pallets and straw, adding OSB to the common training fire fuels, and then furnishing one of the rooms as if it were a living room setup, we're looking to see if you can create ventilation-limited conditions in a burn building. We've placed instruments throughout the building, gas concentrations in the fire room to identify ventilation-limited conditions, temperature sensors to look at fire growth and potential regrowth, velocity probes to look at the flow paths within the structure. By measuring gas concentration in four locations in the fire room, we can determine whether the fire has gone ventilation-limited or still has enough oxygen to reach its peak heat release rate. In addition to these normal instruments, we've looked at how does turnout gear function in the training environment. Using samples of turnout gear placed over heat flux gauges and temperature sensors, we're able to identify how heat is being transferred through the turnout gear to the potential firefighter beneath. We're also looking at what exposure potential exists during training fires as different fuel packages are used. Monitoring for flame retardants, VOCs, and carcinogenic agents, we're trying to determine whether different fuel configurations increase or decrease the exposure to firefighters. The ultimate goal of this project is to try and increase the fidelity of training while maintaining the level of safety expected.